what I saw in the spirit. Something just broke, and I saw angels stepping into the rooms of people. You need to understand that spiritual activity is born out of understanding. And when you use understanding to carry out spiritual activity, testimonies are inevitable. The ball of anointing that just hits this room right now by those statements that are made, what I saw in the spirit, something just broke, and I saw angels stepping into the rooms of people. You need to understand that spiritual activity is born out of understanding. And
we're here with you once again from the studios of Cosmopolitan TV with this special edition of Breakthrough Morning Devotion live with God's choice servant, Pastor Obed Obenyadeh. And today is the last day. Today is where we traverse the final lap of this special edition of the transmission. Now, the man of God said he received an express instruction from God to come our way with tools to equip us to traverse this season of December as victors in Christ Jesus. Today is the last day of this session, and I know that in the past 2 days, you've been extremely blessed, you've been extremely touched, you've received tremendous help of God, even as we went through these deep secrets and mysteries in the kingdom of God. At this moment, this is what I want you to do. I want you to share the link. I want you to share the link. Wherever you are watching us from, across whatever social media platform, you are probably watching us on YouTube Live, you are watching us on Facebook Live, I want you to copy the links to the streams. Share them across all your social media platforms. Copy that link, share it on your WhatsApp status. Place it on Twitter, place it on your Facebook wall. Place it on IG, place it everywhere. As much as possible, be that means that extends that hand of invitation to your entire network. Let them catch this blessing. Let them catch this move. Let them be a part of what God is doing on this mountain. And as you do so, you receive your blessing from God. Share the link. Share the link. You can go an extra mile. Probably your mom is asleep. Your dad is asleep. Today is a Saturday. Pick up your phone. Call that family member. Call that loved one. Call someone who you know will be touched specially by today's ministration. Now, if you were with us yesterday, the man of God made us understand what was going to happen today. We're going to have a calling session. We are going to have extended prayer. We are going to have him handle aspects of what will make us victors as we enter into the new year. Do not be selfish. Do not enjoy this alone. I want you to pick up your phone. Call a brother, call a sister, call a loved one. Call someone, let that one know that we are live with Breakthrough Morning Devotion, and God's choice servant, Pastor Obed Obenyadeh, is here to be a blessing. God's choice servant, Pastor Obed Obenyadeh, is here to extend his arm, even as God stretches his arm towards us, to be of that mighty blessing to us. Share the link. Share the link. And like I always say, if you do not share the link, you are not doing well. Now, we are in December. And I said within the past 2 days that we are heading towards our crossover service. Now, our crossover service is the climax service for the year. And also, it is that grand entry, that grand entrance we make into the coming year. It's important how you cross over. It's important where you cross over. It's important who crosses you over. It's important who holds your hand to ensure that you make the most use of all resources available to you in the kingdom of God to enter into the new year. It's important who holds your hand. It's important who teaches you how to cross over. That is why I recommend CCI to you. CCI, where God lives, as our tagline says. I want you to understand that God's choice servant is positioned to ensure that you do not enter the year 2023 like anybody else. God's choice servant is positioned to ensure that you do not end 2022 just like anybody else. There's a way to end the year. There's a way to enter into the new year. And if you've been with us for the past 2 days, then I'm sure you don't need me to tell you what is happening in this season, how to traverse this period, and what to do to make sure that you do not enter into 2023 and 2022 and go on through the whole year of 2023 just being bamboozled by the devil. You need to cross over right. You need to be equipped right for the new year. You need to be at CCI Crossover Service. And here at the headquarters at Asokori Mampon, from where the studios of Cosmopolitan TV are transmitting this Breakthrough Morning Devotion, I want to extend the hand of invitation to all of you across the country, Ghana, across the globe, wherever you are in Africa, wherever you are outside of Africa, this is the place to be. You continually see numbers running across your screen. Just pick any number. From wherever you are, just call and let us know that you want to come for crossover service at CCI. We are going to make appropriate arrangements for you to ensure that that transition is smooth and you are here, welcome, ready to go through our crossover service. You are in anywhere in Ghana. As much as possible, we have locations for the crossover service in all regions in Ghana. We have presence. There's a physical network where you can attend the crossover service. I want you to mark this date on your calendar, 31st December 2022. I want you to mark that date. I want you to take that decision that you will be at crossover service with CCI. You can be in any of our networks. You can be in the virtual church. We have presence here, and we are ready to ensure that you're sailing into the year 2023. It's a smooth one, it's a jolly ride, and it's packed with God's blessings. The highlights and the climax of our crossover service is what God instructed the man of God years ago to do at every crossover service. What is it? It is our miracle pool. Now, mind you, the miracle pool has birthed a lot of wonder. The miracle pool has birthed a lot of testimonies. The miracle pool has delivered God's packages into the hands of his people. Now, I want you to ensure, probably you've been hooked up onto Cosmopolitan TV and I've come across testimonies where people are speaking about their experiences in the pool, what they went through, how things panned out for them, how they received a sure word from God, how they entered into the pool with their desires, and through the running of the year, they saw these things come to pass. This too could be your experience wherever you are. I want you to mark this date on your calendar. I cannot say this enough. Be at CCI Crossover Service, and I know as you endeavor to do so, God is already in position to make sure you come out as a victor. Now, yesterday I started giving various locations and contacts as to how you can be at our CCI Crossover Services. We have a network in Koforidua. In Koforidua, on the crossover night, we are meeting at the Baini Plaza. Baini Plaza, second floor, Galloway traffic light. Yes, Baini Plaza, second floor, Galloway traffic light. It's adjacent to the Ichan House. Baini Plaza, second floor, Galloway traffic light. It's adjacent to the Ichan House. You want to pick this contact if you're in Koforidua in this environs, 055-230-5585. 055-230-5585. Also, you could call 0247-628-298. 0247-628-298. You want to call this contact. Let them know that you want to be at crossover service with CCI to experience the man of God live. And I know you will surely come back with a testimony. Now, we have a network in Australia. We have a network in Australia at the venue 8 Enterprise Street, Salisbury. In Australia, we are at 8 Enterprise Street, Salisbury. Now, this is our only network in Australia. wherever you are in Australia. Probably you are even in another country outside of Australia, but you are closer to Australia than probably you are to Ghana. I want you to make it a point to visit the CCI Australia Network at the 8 Enterprise Street, Salisbury, to make sure that you are present for our crossover service. Now, the contact for our Australia Network is +61 426 575 906. I go over it again. +61 426 575 906. Get in touch with our Australia Network and be present for crossover service. Now, the Auckland Network, venue 2 Park Hill Road, Beaconsfield. Auckland Network, venue 2 Park Hill Road, Beaconsfield. Contact numbers +642 749 24452. +642 749 24452. Alternatively, +642 212 44513. +642 212 44513. Pick up these numbers, call any of the people, and you will be attended to greatly. USA, Georgia. You have a venue for crossover service. Wherever you are in the U.S. and in its environs, you can be present for crossover service live with the man of God to experience the miracle pool life. In USA, Georgia, we are at the Meeting Point Center, 2236 Hayward Road. Meeting Point Center, 2236 Hayward Road, Snellville, postcode GA30039. I go over it again. It's the Meeting Point Center, 2236 Hayward Road, Snellville. Postcode is GA30039. You want to make sure that you are anywhere in the U.S. Pick that flight. Book that flight ahead of time. Visit CCI Georgia for our crossover service, and I know your life will never be the same again, even as you go through the miracle pool, even as you are ministered to one-on-one, even as God's choice servant comes your way right at USA, CCI, Georgia. Techiman. We are back to Ghana. Techiman, we are here with you live with crossover service. The venue is the Bamire Community Center. Now, note this. This is not the original location where they always meet for church. So just note that crossover service is going to happen at a bigger and better place that can accommodate all of you who want to rush in for our service. Techiman, we are the Bamire Community Center. Contact numbers 055-384-8885. 055-384-8885. Another number, 024-401-5320. 024-401-5320. I have a last number for you, 0243-719-405. And just to give you a cue, the last number is the number of the network pastor. So you can call him, he's Pastor Stephen. Make sure that you book your place and you book your seat for CCI crossover service in Techiman. And I know that God is already ready and poised to cross you over into the new year in grand style. Now, Accra, capital city. We are here with you for crossover service in a big, in a grand, in a monumental style. Now, at the Nut Hall near Airtel Tigo head office in Adabraka, we are coming your way with CCI crossover service on the 31st of December. It's at the Nut Hall near the Airtel Tigo head office in Adabraka. CCI Accra is meeting here for our crossover service. Wherever you are in the greater Accra region, you want to make it a point to be at CCI Accra. You want to make your way to the Nut Hall near Airtel Tigo head office at Adabraka so that you too can experience the glory, the joy, the bliss of being in CCI crossover service. Even as you prepare to go through the miracle pool, the man of God is ready to meet you in CCI Accra. Contact number 0244-303-896. 0244-303-896. Alternative contact 0245-175-623. I go over it again. 0245-175-623. Call these numbers ahead of time. Let them know that you want to visit CCI Accra for the crossover service. and God already is ready to meet you at the point of your need. Now, we have the Virtual Church Network, and yes, that's my own network. The venue is Facebook Live, the venue is YouTube Live, the venue is across all social media platforms where you come, where we come your way with transmission of the service. You are probably in a location where there's no CCI service. For one reason or the other, you cannot make your way to any CCI network, but you still want to cross over the year, entering into the new year, I must say, with the man of God, Pastor Obed. You are not left out. Thanks to the internet, we come your way live by the virtual church with the crossover service. You want to pick up these contacts and send WhatsApp messages. 020-619-8245. 020-619-8245 or 0243-271-511. If you've watched the virtual church adverts on TV, these are the contacts you have attached to those, to that advert. You want to call these numbers, let us know where you are, why you'll not be able to go to a physical network, and why that you want to be with us for the crossover service. And I know as you do so, you are connected to the live experience. Now in Takwa, we are the University of Mines and Technology Mini Auditorium. Take note, the University of Mines and Technology Mini Auditorium. Contact numbers 0544-708-459. 0544-708-459. Again, 0544-708-459. You want to pick this number, call if you are in Takwa. Let them know that you want to be live with us for CCI crossover service. And I know that your experience will be the same and exact wherever you are. In Ho, we are the last floor of the Ram's Horn building. Last floor of the Ram's Horn building after Redeem Junction near the Soldiers' Barracks. Last floor of the Ram's Horn building after Redeem Junction near the Soldiers' Barracks. Contact numbers 050-456-2625. 050-456-2625. Or 0245-175-623. 0245-175-623. Wherever you are in Ho, you want to make it a point to call these numbers to visit our network in Ho for the CCI crossover service. Wherever you are in the Volta region, you can make your way to CCI Ho for that experience with God at our crossover service. Out of Ghana again, here I am at Vietnam in the Bien Hoa City. Vietnam in the Bien Hoa City. The venue is 14/16, the Pegasus Plaza, 5355D, VO Thi Sao. Pardon my pronunciation for those of you who are in Vietnam. VO Thi Sao, Quyet Thang, Bien Hoa City. Contact number plus 843-594-27498. Plus 843-594-27498. Get in touch with our contact person in Vietnam. Let them know you're coming for CCI crossover service. You are in Vietnam, you are in the neighboring countries. You can make it to Vietnam for the crossover service. Please make sure you mark this date on your calendar. You make arrangements, and I know that your experience would be mega. Your experience would be a Pegasus one, just like the Pegasus Plaza. Now, in Nyangpala, back home in Ghana, we are the University for Development Studies, UDS, Nyangpala Campus. Contact numbers 0241-3637-397. 0241-3637-397. Alternative contact 050-379-4037. You want to pick these numbers if you are in Nyangpala and its environs. You want to call them. You want them to know you want to be at Nyangpala Campus CCI Network for our crossover service. And I know you would have an awesome experience in Christ. We are in Bolgatanga, still remaining up north. Bolgatanga, Swapi Restaurant, SNIT Office Traffic Light. Swapi Restaurant, SNIT Office Traffic Light. Contact number 0249-751-589. Alternative contact 0248-90688. 0249-0248. Now, you want to make sure that you get in touch with the people. If you need arrangements made for you for accommodation, for whatever, you just need to reach out to us early so that we could make whatever arrangement for you. Now, Cape Coast. We are the top floor of the Suntech building at Kakumdo, opposite Wesley Girls High School. Top floor of the Suntech building at Kakumdo, opposite the Wesley Girls High School. Contact number 0247-768-270. 0247-768-270. You are in Cape Coast. You are anywhere in the central region. You can make it to this network to have this physical experience in Christ at our crossover service. Top floor, Suntech building, Kakumdo, opposite Wesley Girls High School. Pick up the contact and get in touch with our personnel to make whatever arrangements you need for you. Sunyani, we are at the Chesville Hotel off the Berlin Top Road. Sunyani, Chesville Hotel off the Berlin Top Road, 200 meters away from the UENR roundabout. Contact number 0245-361-1776. 0245-361-1776. 050-371-2838. Now, reach out to us. Let us make arrangements for you. Let us know you want to be at our Sunyani network for the CCI crossover service. And I know your experience will be wonderful in Christ. Pram Pram Network, we are here with you at the Turret Filling Station, formerly Galaxy Oil Filling Station, which is near the Ahoto Guest House. Now, understand that your experience at crossover is going to be full of that Ahoto. You are going to have peace. You are going to have glory. You are going to see manifestation of what God wants to do for you. Contact number 0248-319-778. Now, Asante Mampong, we are the Amosted Campus opposite Afrakoma Hostel. Contact number 0246-656266 or 0544-633-789. Amosted Campus opposite Afrakoma Hostel at Asante Mampong. Crossover service is live with you also in Obuase at the Maoli Hostel at Bidiem off Dunkwa Road. Contact number 0543-882258 or 0241-014476. Going back up north, we are also in Tamale at the Aliu Mahama Sports Stadium, Gado Hall. Aliu Mahama Sports Stadium at the Gado Hall. Big place to accommodate all of you. Anywhere in Tamale and its environs, contact number 0245-523-9915, 0245-523-9915, or 0240-425-239. Now, these are the locations in Ghana and beyond where you could make a physical entrance at our crossover service. You want to mark this date on your calendar. You want to start preparing even from now. I've listed all the networks. I've listed all the locations for our crossover service, both in and outside Ghana. What you want to do is to just do a mapping of which location is close to you. Decide to prepare to go for crossover service. And like the man of God has said yesterday and 2 days ago, that he's praying specially over the waters of the miracle pool here. He started that already. And we are going to fetch gallons of water and send it to all the various networks, as I have mentioned, and more. Now, this is what's going to happen. The miracle pool there is going to be infested with the waters that have been ministered over, that the angels have touched from here. You want to make sure that you make a physical entry into any of our networks for the crossover service, and I know your life will never be the same again. Today is the last day of this special Breakthrough Morning devotion. And like I said yesterday, there's an attitude you should have that I picked from the opening of this special service. What a great opening you have made for yourself. Because of this, you shall be called Perez. What a great opening you have made for yourself. You have to decide. Today is the last day. The man of God is going to receive calls. The man of God is going to be praying for you specially. The man of God is going to be releasing this special prophetic token. Do not just be a hearer. Decide that whatever part you have to play to make sure that you go through this period, ending and climaxing today in grand style, is done by you. When you are asked to sow seeds, make sure you sow seeds. When you are asked to undertake the prophetic direction, make sure you do it with all diligence. Anything that you are asked to do by the man of God, Mary told the disciples, he says, whatever he says you should do, do it. That should be your attitude, so that great opening can be made for you even in today's service as we transmit live from the studios of Cosmopolitan TV. Close your eyes with me wherever you are. Jesus.
Shalom, I want you to lift up your voice and begin to bless the name of the Lord as we worship God in the language of the Spirit with a song. Come on, lift your voice and begin to bless the name of the Lord.
the ball of anointing that just hits this room right now by those statements that are made, what I saw in the spirit, something just broke. And I saw angels stepping into the rooms of people. Carry out spiritual activity. Testimonies are inevitable. The ball of anointing that just hits this room right now by those statements that are made, what I saw in the spirit, something just broke, and I saw angels stepping into the rooms of people. You need to understand that spiritual activity is born out of understanding. And when you use understanding to carry out spiritual activity, testimonies are inevitable.
Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the blood. Jinendon ke monde stali bakarando sevredis. Oh. Mo de ka de keso tene mele babarado simbrehiko. Worship the Lord. Bless his name. Exalt him. What a day. O grendo sendre histo libra hadasade. Jesus. Onyankopon, yonu kwafo. Orima wanso minje. Ni ametu. Metu mieji na no. Onyankopon ye no kwafo. Onyankopon yo no kwafo. Ama won somehwe. Orima won somehwe. Ni ametu mi ejina no. Ni ametu. Metu mi ejina no. Onyankopon yo no kwafo. Onyankopon yo no kwafo. Orima won somehwe ni ametu metu mi ejina no.
God is faithful.
Onyankopon yo no kwafo.
God is faithful.
Orima won somehwe
or allow temptations
ni ametu metu mieji na no na emom na emom na emom obe makwanya da ho obe makwanya da ho na mi die free and so she imu na mi die free and so she imu
I come out of this
na emom na emom obe makwayada ho na mi die free na mi die free mi so she imo na emom obe makwayada ho na emom obe makwayada ho Namidia free. Namidia free.
I come out of this room.
And so shame. Naemo. Naemo. Obe ma kwaya dao. Namidia free. Namidia free. Soreimo, soreimo, Yanko Pong, you're no quarrel for Yanko Pong, you're no quarrel for Orema was so mere,
not allowed that I
am a two, Metu, Mietina, no. Yankupon, you're no quarrel for
this faithful.
Orima once saw me head.
Not allowed that I be
tempted. Niametu, metu, mejina, no.
You're what I can
do. God is faithful. Jesus, no temptation has ever overtaken us than that which is common to all men. And with it, he will make a way of escape. Yankupon ya no kwarfo orima wanso minje niametu metu mieji na no. Yankupon, you're no quarrel. Orima wants some me. Na metu, metu mieji na no. Naemo, naemo. Obema kwaya da. Namidia free, so jaymo. And so jaymo. Naemo, naemo. Obema kwaya da. Namidia free, namidia free. And so jaymo. Nyankopon ye no kwarfo. Amma en socha wuntumi nyina no emaso. Ne awufemu ene. Onam breakthrough morning devotion yiso. Ebe ma kwan ada ho. Na wonam how much empire no sorry is every sensation.
No temptation is going to overtake you beyond what is common to man, and by virtue of this breakthrough morning devotion, God is providing a way of escape to come out of that temptation.
Naemom obema kwaya da ho. Na would ye free and so shame mo na emom obema kwaya da ho na would ye free and so shame mo. Na emom obema kwaya da ho na wudi e free and so she imo na emom obema kwaya da ho. Jesus. Nah. would ye free, and so share ye more. Nay, more. Obe ma kwai adaho. Yamina, she said, yes, ma kwai bi adaho ma wate. Would be free sans so share ye more. In so share ye more. Na emo obema kwaya da ho na wudi e free and so she imo.
The song just reiterates the scripture that the Lord will not allow any temptation to overtake you aside that which is common to man. Even in this, he will provide a way of escape, so that you will come out from that temptation and
scar. And that day, a dance.
Today is special.
Me de nyamia sem sima kume bi rebrew.
I bring you the word of God today.
Me nchere hu.
Not going to stay long on this.
Na me wia me de ho akwanchere susu egufom.
After this, like I said, I'm going to release prophetic directions.
Na odudu a wo me di ye chiri. Nansen.
All of you who have been with us in the past 3 days, you would have a basis and a firm foundation that will enable you to override the works of the enemy. Every year, you would have to take note and mark the first and the last month of the year. That's the first and the 12th month of each year. The Lord is true. His word is sure.
That's the 12th month.
Today I bring you a mystery concerning the 12th month of the year. I said, the word of the Lord is true. Do you know that the marketplace as we have it, in the past 3 days, I've made you understand that the marketplace as we have it is just not as it is physically.
Mama wa hunu sunsun.
I've made you understand what happens spiritually.
Ebeko afine wie ya.
Just as the year is about to end.
En shishedia ewom.
There are many arrangements.
Eni eniama sunsun mu ekoso.
There are many orchestrations in the realm of the spirit.
Ahonhom a ye free po ani atoye emframem owiem ensuom ebakrom.
Made you understand how the multitudes of spirits from the east, from the west, from the wind, from the waters invade our physical earth.
Nani yinemu, mama we hunu se enye nipa nyina wuhu wo mo si ye nam ho enye ye nipa.
In all of this, I made you understand concerning the classes of men, how that not all men you see belong to the same class and fall under the same classification.
Se wo bi ADD ana se wo bi edin komo.
Again, I made you understand that the fact that you see a man eat or converse or go about normal human activities does not mean he is a man belonging to the class as you and I.
Papa Yankopon Besra Abraham Ebedidi.
We saw how that God visited Abraham. He ate. However, he was still God.
Sarah.
Prepared food, stew.
Emma Papa Nyankopon eto nsa tenen nsa di.
And scripture makes us understand that God ate this food that Sarah prepared.
Na ma oti ase se.
Again, I made you understand.
Na eye bosumi no ana se bosumi a eye afi no ewie.
That it was the end of the year.
Awon mo ma se womu tu fa.
You have to understand that spirits do not just invade a place. Now you have to understand that when spirits invade a place, they do not come with such explicit descriptions as we see probably being depicted, that you see a spirit flying with wings. Now, I made you understand that there are certain notable characteristics that a spirit will exhibit. This is the means by which you know that you've met a spirit. Now, I spoke about referencing from the book of Job, how that a spirit passed before him, and then all the hair of his skin stood up. Now, scripture also makes us understand the mystery behind such beings, how that they can have very special, distinctive features, and they invoke fear. The word of the Lord makes us understand. In the scriptures, there was a spirit made himself manifest and visited a man and his wife. In the midst of the conversation, this spirit was asked, "What is your name?"
No, okay, I said, "Midini die eye hintasem na midini ye onwanwa."
He said, "My name is a mystery, but my name is wonder."
Okay, I said, "Midini ye secret, midini eye hintasem na midini eye onwanwa."
He said that his name is secret and his name is wonderful.
Na abra oni kroyire eni sa tumi ni shia ye wie ye. I won't sir encounter no more sem actually nukruno. Or can send so dear be am I yedihunu senia a home ba won soon one by etie.
Now if we understand this scriptural reference, we know that when his wife was recounting the events of the entry of the spirit to her husband, she distincted certain characteristics that make us know how spirits make themselves manifest. Because of this, the feelings you are going to have, and the characteristics, notable characteristics of that spirit entity, will make you know that if you're able to observe certain key features of this spirit, you would know that there's something different.
Ne countenance a wodi gina ho no. Ani anwodin bia wo kuta. Ani ne niye bia oyɛ no. Enye nipa adwene ani etumi de yɛsaade no.
So there are distinctive features involving the countenance, the activity of this being, which you might mistake him for a man, and then the aura of this being. You will note that there are distinctive features about this that make you know that it doesn't belong to the class of men that you are all aware about.
And unti, ye kan in the book of Judges, chapter 13. E waka krano, ye ntie adansia, ne yere no, e kafa, sunsumwa ebesra no no, e wansem.
So in the book of Judges, chapter 13, verse 20, we read, "For it came to pass, when the flame went up toward heaven from
on kind free
the
verse
altar,
15, Emra from.
From verse 15. And Manoah said unto the angel of the Lord, I pray thee, let us detain thee until we shall have made ready a kid for thee. 16. And the angel of the Lord said unto Manoah, though thou detain me, I will not eat of thy bread. And if thou wilt offer a burnt offering, thou must offer it unto the Lord. For Manoah knew not that he was an angel of the Lord. Verse 17. And Manoah said unto the angel of the Lord, what is thy name, that when thy sayings come to pass, we may do thee honor? And the angel of the Lord said unto him, why askest thou this after my name, seeing it is secret?
And he intercepted me with what? A fat senior, a home best nipa.
Now, this verse of scripture makes us understand that there's a certain secret, there's a certain mystery about the visitation of angels or of spirit beings that you have to take note of, otherwise you would miss.
Or say,
he said,
your friend saying,
what is your name?
Uye ni pabeng.
Who are you?
Ufri himfa.
Where are you from?
Na sun sum ni to me ne kachre ne se. Ade na wubi sami sadie yi. Efri se, asemwa wubi sami no, eye ehin kasem.
Verse 18 says, the angel of the Lord said unto him, why askest thou this after my name, seeing it is secret?
Enti ene, efri nansa, edibepim ene, en semwa, ye chuchu won komo chresem no, eye ehin kasemwa.
Now, I want you to understand that for the past 2 days, even climaxing today, we have been speaking of secret things. We have been speaking of mysteries.
Now, near me, depa kese kese, about the book of Judges concerning Manoah and the wife, Asemono, aye verse 6.
Now, what makes a lot of joy well up in my heart concerning this experience of Manoah and his wife is what we see recounted in verse 6. He says, then the woman came and told her husband, saying, a man of God came unto me.
Oye nipo, nenzwa ye bafu. A man of God came unto me.
And his countenance was like the countenance of an angel of God.
Tobo. Oye nipa, nenzwa nisu te se bafu.
He is a man. However, his countenance was like that of an angel. I reiterate, he is a man. However, his countenance is like that of an angel.
A man of God came unto me. But onyatin can be said, there be when ye nipa, but oye nipa. Okita nipa, dibia, nenso.
When his wife encountered this person, she knew it was a man. However, there was just something different about this man. And then further confirming in his countenance, she said, no, this was like an angel of God, though he was a man.
A man of God came unto me, and his countenance was like the countenance of an angel of God. And here what he says, very terrible.
Very terrible.
Very terrible. Very terrible. Easy English, no? Any message Bible. Ewa kwaya o putinwa. Emani ye de. Emani ba out ye.
Now, in the Easy English version and the Message Bible version, I take the Message. The woman went to her husband
and said,
a man of God came to me.
He looked
like the angel of God.
Terror.
Lays. With glory.
Na enyonyam.
Jesus.
Akram.
Terror laced with glory.
Easy English, no?
The woman went and told her husband. She said, a man of God came to me. He looked like someone sent by God.
He
was very powerful.
You're powerful now.
Haven't you met a powerful being before?
Try otikokoso. Konenimusa na abe hunu se odanso.
Now try the king of the Ashanti kingdom, and you know
very
men come in class.
Powerful.
You'll be able to note that he's very powerful.
A subini bain bia a girano, a man who ne sans a way free yamimuninti and yonyam a girano.
Now, there's terror laced with glory, as the Message Bible puts it, especially because this being is a being from God. You can see the evident glory of God that accompanies such a being, he exudes it.
Anunti,
thus,
bisahonse,
ask yourself the question. Have you ever met any kind of man?
Or ye nyankopon sumafo?
Sent of God.
Ah, one nan wedi anchor, nenso, esusu se. Wei? Or ye nyaminipa?
He didn't reveal himself to you. He didn't tell you anything about his identity. But all of a sudden, he's able to know that you are sent from God.
Paul. Am I yehun say hintasimi?
Paul made us understand this mystery.
Or see, Abraham,
said, when I came to you,
Man yi me se nipa bi keke.
You didn't receive me like a mere man.
Nemo mo je me se onyankopon bofo somafo.
You received me as an angel of God, as a messenger of
Empo.
God.
Ti se Yesu Kristo ankasa.
Even as Jesus Christ himself.
Ehupa.
This is grief.
Sorry ano pana se ube pia.
When you're stepping out in the morning,
sheye,
take note. Take heed to yourself and note the different classes of men you are going to meet. In Galatians 4:14, Papa, he says, and my temptation, which was in my flesh, he despised not, nor rejected, but received me as an angel of God, even as Christ Jesus.
Kind of message, no, not any day.
Now in the message verse.
Kind of message, no, not any day.
And don't you remember that even though taking in a sick guest.
Guest. I was a guest.
Even a sick guest.
A sick guest. Bible say, many have entertained angels, messengers, unawares. Nkofobe bre e shia abofo. Ni san se se nyinta semu ebia ya nchre no asori nti ana se one ye conscious of the spirit realm nti na dipa bi ahwere no.
Scripture makes us understand that you should not be mindful to entertain strangers because maybe thus have entertained angels and unawares. Now, because of lack of knowledge, because of ignorance, because adequate and proper teaching has not been delivered unto you, you probably have met an angel. You probably met a messenger of God. And because you could not discern, you missed the package and the blessing God had for you.
Now read the entire message Bible.
And
it comes out with life and with power.
That even though taking in a sick guest was most troublesome for you, you chose to treat me well as you would have treated an angel of God.
Point one, I was a guest. You treated me as an angel of God as well as you would have treated Jesus himself.
If he had visited you.
So these are times of visitation.
So, Papa, an angel could appear to you.
Yes.
A spirit being from heaven.
Yes.
And probably even be like, this angel is sick.
Yes.
Because you were talking about normal activity. So, the angel is eating.
Yes.
The angel probably is bathing.
Yes.
And because you do
and
not
you know,
know
what? Lots of the times, the sick people we see on the streets are not men. So, I'm coming to that.
Wow.
A lot of the blind people you see, the lame that you see, in the highways, loads of them are not men.
Interesting.
Or the subi. Emma Unu say no. Onyenipa. Now onyenipa if you neche say. If that say nyamina asumanu. And I say bonsam and asumanu.
Now, like the man of God said, loads of people you meet by the street, especially in the highway, as we saw yesterday. Said that he said the lame, the sick, the crippled, you meet probably standing by the road or seated begging, are not all men. Now, there are certain distinctive characteristics, like he has taught us some and will still teach us more, by which you would know what kind of being you've encountered. However, those characteristics distinct them. They are either sent from God or sent by the devil. That is where discernment becomes primary.
I don't think Yankupa say in the book of Hebrews or say you have entertained strangers. Strangers.
Be not forgetful to entertain strangers. For thereby some have entertained angels
unawares.
Let me teach you something.
Jesus.
That's interesting.
Okay, me pema komenim.
I advance.
Me remember where a breakthrough morning devotion. When you soon soon sem.
This is breakthrough morning devotion. This is not soon
soon. Soon soon sem. You be pemre ni atre. A quiet abehunu say nipa wish yani. How to distinguish godly strangers from evil strangers. You be pemre ni a yes head humani ye.
I mean, sure, Papa.
But number one, a quiet our fast to de be a shenin so nipa will tell ya wom. Send ye be ya wa fufro, ebe remwa. Ube to me be sound said, this is a stranger. What kind? Godly stranger? Mere stranger, satanic stranger. The first things to look out for is the countenance by which they come. Paul walked into the midst of the Galatian church as a sick guest. Yet he was the apostle of God. A sick guest. Yet he was the apostle of God. He said, and don't you remember that even though taking in a sick guest, even though taking in a sick guest, sana bon samsu sube timi esiesie, o yarefua o jina kwa hum. Ah, what did you see? Now, what do you want to say? I'm going to say,
I remember certain ministrations in church, at least one notable one way back at the Haven, where you ministered to someone who has been going through a lot of financial difficulties and said, your problem was the fact that you saw somebody and gave him money.
Yes.
You thought he was sick.
And I described the person.
Exactly.
And the person remembered who I was talking about. Now, what does it mean? It simply tells you that even though people stand by the road, there was some striking thing about this person. Yet, he didn't take notice of the striking semblance and still went ahead to drop the money, without contacting the Holy Spirit of God.
So even to do good,
you have to be sensitive.
You have to be sensitive.
Yes. Sensitive so you don't miss your visitation. And sensitive so that you do not receive the son of wickedness.
Everybody, especially in this season where there has been this much infiltration of these spirits. I wonder how many of us, probably Papa, with an innocent and a good heart, feel like we are doing good. Because you see, a lot of people do donations and stuff in this season.
Yes.
Who are we donating to? I'm asking you. Who are you laying your life aside for?
God willing, today I have so much to share. God willing, I'll make time. I promise soon, viewers, I'll make time and share how to discern strangers. Okay, my main child, dear Baco.
I'm giving you this gift.
Me two bomb kesiye.
This is a huge explosive bomb.
Me nimse ngovo baby aye crowd.
A lot of people already. I'll explain this later.
Hey, aya shese owusun sumwa.
Wow.
Shadow. Oni shadowa me mano onye nipa.
Wow.
Because spirit eni shadow or ye image into onto me nya image. Dafo from echre. Ushi obi wo kwem no srese ska. Aya to any chef form. Aya very simple. And you may be on my own. And you may be on my own. This only a soon soon nipa emma nitro. What's often to mean snow at your way?
Now, you
have a tobo, my cast and me. What's often to mean snow at your way? Obeka se kobon pie. Obeka se peace in your heart. Off from quine way and fair peace. Udi peace and a bear. There be Nyami bofuaba. Soon suma ba on chain. Or your soon soon bay. Number one. Soon soon ni soon soon.
Simple, profound.
Very simple. We are from where say? Soon soon di nechia. Buff will be anywhere about soon soon di nechi.
Now, simple check. Like I said, this cannot be revealed to you just by a pastor. You need to be a spiritual man to know these things. And we are gifted to have a spiritual man teach us these things. Very simple check. Now, for you probably, all you know is that, let me consult the Holy Spirit. How do I know who is a good person? How do I know who to give someone to? You are probably looking for peace in your heart, forgetting that peace is just an error name. Now, listen. This is a very simple yet profound way of discernment in the spirit. An image doesn't have an image because a spirit being is already an image. You as a man have a shadow. A spirit being, there's no angel that comes with a shadow. How do you know, as a quick check, who to give someone something to, probably you met randomly? Check. Does he have a shadow? He doesn't have a shadow, don't give anything to him.
NGT, Job can say, a spirit. pass before me. A spirit passed before me. Now, Obi was say, the hair of my flesh stood up. Verse 16. It stood still, but I could not discern the form thereof. Me who nipano. I don't say an image was before my eyes. At that moment, what capture image into me? Nya image.
Now, Job brings out this very well. He says that the spirit stood still. I could not discern the form thereof. An image was before my eyes. An image cannot have an image. This is a spirit being.
Asensodia baako 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 enson ene wo ho.
There are seven means or seven distinct characteristics by which you will be able to discern a being.
So obi abesra me. Mesiden hu se oye oye osunafo. Oye nipa na onye nipa. Very simple.
Someone has visited you. How would you know what class of man that person belongs to?
Matobom baako ensia no mechia wo sunsun mi. And then to me, because I said, and you see, handle Janus.
Today, we want to handle Janus, and I'll go into this like I've promised on Sun Sun Munsem at a later date. But however, I want to handle Janus.
So, in the midst of all that we're sharing, we're realizing that strangers that are spirit beings come on visitations. Get that right. Get it right. This earth and this world existed before you came. Iriasi we wohwa ansa na wohoba. Emun semne suma semne hintasem. E woho fritetetete. Enunti uti riasi nasi. Na unu sunsun. Senya ededi. E woho namenia. Ema unu senya abesisi wanamon. Eni senya.
Now, just understand, like Jesus said, mysteries have been before the foundation of the world. So, when you are given the proper teaching and it's explained to you how this world is operating and the things that govern life in this world, it's easy for you because then you know how to conduct yourself in conformance to the ordinances of the world.
This
always happens with Papa. I'll give one in the end, I'll give two or three or four. I'm giving you the second distinctive feature.
Spirit, any pupil.
Spirit beings do not have pupils, the part of the eye, that inner small.
Oh, we knew what then, so any pupil.
So the spirit has eyeballs, but in that eyeball, there's no pupil.
Oh, Bibanas was sure who sika on. Aya sheminiasi. Na hwese enikoshia fita eni tuntum ba na simfimfini no imfimfini no ebi wo ho ana mi so ahyense de na ye 7
I said there
na me si anka me kire ba akope me de ba akwa so so eni de da bi mi nkomani mbi
Now I said I was going to give you just one distinctive feature. I've told you there are 7 and I'll teach them on a later date, but I'm adding another one. Spirit beings do not have pupils. Now, if you understand the part of the eye, you know the cornea, you know the iris, and you know the pupil. Someone is begging you for money. Look straight into the eyes of such a being. Do you see the cornea? Do you see the iris? You would note that there is no pupil. If there's no pupil, don't give that person that money.
Now, sad diagnosis where they are so for diagnosis.
Now, beyond this is the diagnosis to identify who a witch is and who a witch is not.
Onipa na ehye neni ase. Enu nti na mpenimfo ka asasem. Enti se biibi so obi eni ase abesi de hu.
You see, there's a tree proverb and an advent that says that there's witchcraft that is under the eyes of someone, that I'm translating literally. Now, how would you know that somebody has an evil spirit or somebody is a possessor of an evil craft? It is by looking into the eye.
People na etia neni ase ho no. Ubehu no se so nipa na ye sunsun ana oyehohom a. Esimisu se mi ntwa so. I'm in training.
I'm going to heed to this instruction. I know you came here today specially because you wanted prophetic directions and know how to enter the year. That's what I'm going to continue.
Papa Yesu, Odan Wedino, Kokan Tresem, Neniasi, Senya Netie.
Even scripture makes us understand the nature of Jesus' eyes.
Odan Wedi, Ewen Yonyem, Nisunen Nebain, Oba Woni Passesu, Nisunen Nebain. Papa Yesu, Neniasi, na etesei, niya onim no onim, koka interesem.
When you read the scripture, when Jesus revealed himself in glory, there was a distinctive description about his eyes. Go and read the scripture. If you know, you know.
Mount of Transfiguration. Na Yesu, na niti, na etesei.
On the Mount of Transfiguration, what was the nature of Jesus' head?
12th month of the year. It's a month of distraction. Can you trace him in the book of Esther? Esther, the chapter number 3, the chapter number 2, from the verse 16 downwards.
So Esther was taken unto King Ahasuerus into his house royal in the 10th month, which is the month of Tebeth in the 7th year of his reign.
Esther chapter 3, the verse 7 and the verse 13.
3, 7 and 13.
Uh-huh. In the first month,
uh-huh. That is the month of Nisan, mm-hmm. In the 12th year of King Ahasuerus, they cast pur, that mm-hmm. is the lot, before Haman from day to day and from month to month to the 12th month. That is the month Adar.
Verse 13.
Okay, 13. And the letters were sent by post into all the king's provinces to destroy, to kill, and to cause to perish all Jews, both young and old, little children and women, in one day, even upon the 13th day of the 12th month, which is the month Adar, and to take the spoil of them for a prey.
What was to happen in the 12th month?
To destroy.
To kill. To cause to perish. All Jews, both young and old, little children and women, in one day, even upon the 13th day of the 12th month. Well, what fear will mean? 12 months, a month, babe. Send me away programming at the end. 12 months, no, a month, babe.
What is the 12th month in your calendar?
To kill, to cause to perish, to destroy. All the Jews. Remember yesterday we realized it is to wear out the saints. Chapter 9, the verse number 1 of the book of Esther. Chocho and Umeguo, Daniel chapter 4, 29 to 32. Now, in the 12th month,
That is the month Adar, on the 13th day of the same, when the king's commandment and his decree drew near to be put in execution, in the day that the enemies of the Jews hope to have power over them.
Hold on. In the 12th month, your enemies hope to have power over you. The Bible says, though it was tamed to the contrary.
This is the prayer we are praying today. Scripture says, though it was tamed to the contrary. Brother, you have to be vigilant.
12 months.
This is the mystery of the 12th month. There are many more.
Your enemies want to have power over you financially. Enemies want to have power over you influentially. Enemies want to have power over you by destroying and by killing you, by bringing you to your wit's end, by wearing out the saints. From the past 2 days, if you've been following, you realize that this third day, I have put the discourse of the first and the second day together. I went further to talk to you about the first day, spirits, and how they operate in their visitation. Please, don't overlook the 12th month of every calendar year. emi weni ngu bosumi ya. Eya bosumi ya tosu dumi enu. Ewa afibi emu. Kalande biya wu yusu no. 12 months no. Eye crucial.
Don't overlook the 12th month of every calendar year, irrespective of whatever calendar you are programmed by. Note that in the 12th month, there are very critical things that happen.
12th month, biara susu, eye a month of lamentation.
Every 12th month is a month of lamentation.
Ezekiel chapter 32. Me pese honum susu ye ko kaina wo shade. Ezekiel 32 from the verse 1 to the verse 8.
Ezekiel 32, 1 to 8. And it came to pass in the 12th year.
In the 12th year.
In the 12th month.
In the 12th month.
In the first day of the month.
Tobo. Yes, I will 12 months.
Another 12 month indication here.
It came to pass in the 12th year.
In the 12th month.
In the 12th month.
In the first day of the month.
In the first day of the month.
And the word of the Lord came unto me saying.
Said the aim.
Son of man, take up a lamentation for Pharaoh, king of Egypt. And say unto him,
mm-hmm.
Thou art like a young lion of the nations,
mm-hmm.
and thou art as a whale in the seas,
mm-hmm.
and thou camest forth with thy rivers, and troublest the waters with thy feet, and foulest their rivers.
Mm-hmm.
Thus saith the Lord God, I will therefore spread out my net over thee with a company of many people, and they shall bring thee up in my net.
Four.
Then will I leave thee upon the land, I will cast thee forth upon the open field, and will cause all the fowls of the heaven to remain upon thee, and I'll fill the beasts of the whole earth with thee. And I will lay thy flesh upon the mountains, and fill the valleys with thy height. 6.
To verse 8.
And I will also water with thy blood the land wherein thou swimmest, even to the mountains.
Hold on. Jesus. December, bosomi, dear Nekos.
What happens in the month of December?
I will also water with your blood the land. I will also water with your blood the land. Midi umoja ebe pitting as our sinister. Verse 1, or see, take up a lamentation. In the 12th month, sa na nyamia program no, and was self was usu hunu sa no, onu susu de ne calendar abeshim. Sa ni esadi a 12th month no, eye mojasem. Asemo amiki, unkai Bible okura wuni muse December to January no, e wuwu basa basa accident basa obisio eye because a driver for ne pentem, wamo pentem, a driver for ne pentem. Omo pentema koin bisa beyifobia wo camp say abreben ye pe moja e wo wiase mu nyina.
Now interestingly, you do not need the scriptures to tell you about watering the land with blood during this season. A lot of accidents during this season, a lot of deaths. Now people will attribute it to the fact that there's hurried nature of life and transactions in this period. However, ask the witches, those who know what they do. Now, Papa, talking of asking and calendars, this is from Otis Ledlow. Interesting facts he brings to bear. He's in China. And because of what you spoke about in the third month, he says COVID-19 started, and you know there's wide speculations that this was the source of the COVID. It started here in China in December and escalated in January.
Pepe. Say a month of lamentation. Month of lamentation. And a uremunu. And say why when year no em tutu anamon e wo sunsun se na esefata u be shi amane.
You have to understand that if you do not do the right things in this month of December entering into January, you will become a casualty.
U be shi amane hunu,
you will become a casualty, you become a victim of a lot of trauma.
And someone here can in the a different unanimous set, sanity.
All prophets know that what I'm saying today is true.
A different unanimous set, no passem, and yet it to a din.
All prophets know that I'm revealing truth.
A dear dancer, and they say, Ubenya defua or yet treful.
Now,
uncle,
it's a blessing to have a prophet teacher, one who can explain the mysteries of the spirit realm and bring it to your basic, simple understanding.
enye so wo chirechire mu kwa na mum nyame asem wo be gina so di achirechirem.
Again, not just mere explanations, but to hinge on the word of God as a pillar to speak and elucidate on these matters.
What is I want to say? Adan na December ewuwu January atofuwo bebrebe koso sa de na nyame asem wo ka.
Have you asked yourself, how come in December, in January, we have a lot of premature deaths, we have a lot of accidents, we have a lot of people going this way? What's the reason?
If we say, calendar BR 12 months, are dangerous?
It's because no matter what calendar you are using, the 12th month is dangerous. You have to be vigilant. You have to be very careful.
And do you know what?
Papa.
The 12th month is a month of lamentation. Mm-hmm. A month where your enemies want to have power over you. Mm-hmm. A month where the enemy comes in to destroy and to kill.
Where the thief
cometh not, but to kill, to destroy. Where the land is watered with blood.
This is it.
PVC, this is. This is 3 days of special edition of Breakthrough Time. Now, when you enter, yes, you share, sir. Do you know that? May round it up quickly. I have so much to say. In the 12th month, as programmed by God, is also the month of divine intervention. Because it was within that month that the word of God shows clearly that the Jews received intervention in that 12th month. You can read the book of Jeremiah. You can read the book of 2 Kings. And you would realize that the 12th month of every calendar year, because of how it's been programmed, you need divine intervention. And do you know what? Don't be late. I said, don't be late. Why do I say don't be late? Make sure that the 10th day, the 11th day, and the 12th day of the 12th month, you do something for your soul. 10th day, 11th day, 12th day. Otinasima, 13th day, no tomb. Piao! And you're born somewhere with the block.
Now, on the 10th, 11th, and the 12th day of the 12th month, there are certain spiritual directions you must undertake for your soul. If you neglect this and the 13th day hits you and befalls you without fortification, then you become easy prey for the devil.
Yes. Look at this. In the book of Exodus, when the death angel had to visit the land, the Bible said it was the 12th month.
Yes.
Why? Because after the death angel visited, he said, this shall be the beginning of years, the beginning of man. So you go from the 12th into the beginning, the first.
The first.
And the Bible says it was on the 10th day of that month. Today is the 10th of the month of December. 10-10 is crucial. December is actually 10. But it is the 12th month. 10-10 is crucial. This month shall be unto you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year to you. On the 10th day, or say you will look for the Passover lamb. Do you know? Watch here. The triumphal entry was on the 10th day. What did Jesus do? He had to go through the gateways and overpower the Roman system of Janus, who is the guardian of the gateways and the highways. I bring you the word of light and the word of God. The 10th day of the 12th month. Don't sit and wait for the 13th to meet you without any spiritual action. If you sit back and don't do any divine direction for your soul, you are walking your way into what you know not. The enemy has set traps for the people of God to be caught in a net like fishes, because they know not the times of visitation. The 13th day down through the 26th day is crucial. Listen to me. The 13th day through to the 13 days of the 12th month is dangerous. From 13 December to 26 December, don't joke, 13th December plus 13 days to the 26th of December, don't joke. And yes, I would have moved you. And yes, I would have.
Just as a passing comment, note that you are not celebrating the birthday of Jesus by celebrating Christmas. There's an entire different thing you are engaging you don't know about.
13th day.
From the 13th day onwards, following the 13 days that succeed the 13th day are very grave days.
There are various bad days of every year. And bad days or evil days of every month. But the 12th month, which is the December month, 13 December to 26th, don't joke.
Don't joke with it. In all of this, I know you are wondering. What should I do? Mind you, I promised that today I was going to give you prophetic directions to undertake. To enter into the new year, you must undertake 8 directions to usher yourself rightly. If you're able to note these down, it will be a blessing to you.
Because you're prompting me, say, I come in 5 minutes.
I've been prompted by my floor director that I have 5 minutes more. I'm going to go through them till my 5 minutes are up.
Now, CCI for the same way, met was sorry.
For those of us CCI members, I'll continue this in church. What are the 8 things?
Number one. The beginning of a calendar year must begin with communion. The beginning of a calendar year must begin with communion. To possess the gates of the year, you must possess it by communion.
Anyone who tells you that communion is a thing of the past should be noted. You should mark that person and avoid him. Any pastor who equates communion to reading the word of God, you have to be careful of such a one.
Onipa no or water down spirituality.
That person is watering down spiritually. You have to be mindful, mark, and avoid such
man
a person.
Say, or water down spiritually. Or water down spirituality.
That person is watering down spirituality. Mark and avoid such a one. Number one.
Israel era a new calendar year.
Now understand that when Israel was entering into a new calendar year, they went by communion.
The Passover, the blood cover. Number two, baptism, feet washing. Into Yesu Christu. Obera na dibom at the fufrum. A new creation. Feet washing. NOD communion. Sa kwanchile we ye critical. Ure free a kwanchila medema uni nyinara. Kai. Na make sure say, between the 10th to the 13th. And you see a baby Rafi Fufrum. Obeshe, you were possessing the gates of the month of December into January. Communion number one. Number two, feet washing. Feet washing, you see the Uno and Wasem. Besides, Ebani sent a Jesus Christ or the feet washing by. Because the nation of Israel washed their feet through the Red Sea and through Jordan. Na eno no nyamia se ma yehu no se. Na eye esuba wo bo won esu. E wo mununkum e de ma Moses. Yesu Kristo soso. Odru se wo ko twa owuo. Enje se de da ne nim no. Onumkru wanano. No sansu hohru esua for ne na
se. Now understand that when Jesus was being ushered into the new season of his life, into that new creation aspect of his life, he undertook two things, baptism and feet washing. He took communion and he washed his feet. Now, where was this ordinance of feet washing gotten from? It was gotten from people of ancient Israel. How that they walked through the Red Sea when they were crossing it and had their feet washed. Now, scripture also makes us understand that this same ordinance of feet washing as they were walking through the Red Sea was also baptism into the cloud unto Moses. Critical of the directions that you have to do between the 10th and the 13th as you enter into the new year, a baptism and feet washing. Master Jesus gave us these.
And until a CCI.
Now you have to understand why every CCI member everywhere enters into the new year first by washing his feet. That's how come we have the miracle pool. I said there are eight things you have to do before you enter into the new year.
Communion. Feet washing.
Number one, communion. Number two, feet washing.
Now, sa feet washing also ejinaoma esubo.
Now, this feet washing is also representative of baptism.
Na minyaya kame biye biye muiye. I wish 5 minutes into me boboso.
I wish I could go further into this, but I have just 5 minutes, so I'm rushing.
Ni atosu mi nsa candle. And sorry na ye kasetia candle no munyake ye.
Number three, you have to use an employer candle. A lot of churches speak against candles, and this is something we have to be worried of.
Job, ema yeti asiese.
Job,
obi biara or the candle ebo empire. Ewo no say candle eyo onyankopon han no obo ne kra ho ban ebo ne ma ene ne busua ho ban in the book of Job.
In the book of Job, we are showed how that anyone who prays with a candle fortifies not only his soul but the soul of his family and his descendants and protects all that is his by virtue of using a candle.
Na o kan twere semwa o say when the secret of God was in my tabernacle. Mini emra meb treacher saniama we munina and me see a yinta some secret and I'm di tuja near dikai communion near tosumienu feet washing and I say a subo. Wa wonte a subo ni feet washing as in Bamodiana kotie me message on Hebrew roots the mikvah and kebeya mwamu won crying ubia ubei osimin kamanuntum yentuaso.
Okay, now I said I'm going to reveal eight things you need to do before you enter the year. I'm going to rush through them. I've spoken of baptism. I've spoken of feet washing. Now, the third one I've spoken about is the candle. There's something I was going to give to you who live in Accra with, but the Lord has instructed me to keep quiet. Now, let's go through them. Okay. Get butter.
Enku.
Share butter.
Butter. Media me say butter.
Okay.
Enti Ghana hano muntina ye friend. Share butter. Enkuto. Sunsumun yankuto yeno.
Now I want you to get butter. You will be amazed at the things spiritually that butter accomplishes.
Na me tre unkuto nye ya. Ama sofu biwa Ghana ha.
If I reveal the mystery behind the potency of butter to you, you'll be shocked. Even here in Ghana, there was a prophet of God who so employed this token that he was named after butter.
Yesu Christo obe yasinedi anibena no wodi. Number one, number two.
Yes.
Job nehin taseme eni nisike nyemu nyinara. Na ejina nkutoso. Dafo frenu so meba abetre.
Another day I'm going to go into the mysteries of butter as I've explained. But ask yourself, what food was Jesus eating when he was on earth? Again, Job, his wealth, his abundance, his prominence What did butter do for him? For him to gain this?
A deal for no beer when a dear near a shenan so ah no woody. Yohani Suboni, Nidi any a war. Any into two men. Yesu Christo, Nidi any kosia, any inkuto.
You have to understand that all prophets come with distinct identities and distinct personalities with accompanying distinct meals. So John the Baptist, we know him to have fed on wild locusts and honey. For Jesus, it was butter and eggs. Now, I want you to make sure that you get butter. Just a simple direction. Pray over butter. Before you leave your house, apply some of this butter to your feet. In fact, make that your pomade. Don't buy all these sophisticated stuff in the name of getting proper skin, glowing skin. No. Butter is what you should use.
I say, when I bathed my feet or washed my feet with butter, enkuto, butter, ni chidi ni enkuto no. Obisi enku, jobisi cocoa butter. Bibia butter, sosu bia. But some pie na fire kwanchere. The book of Job. The book of Job. When the tabernacle of God, the candle of the Lord, was upon my head. Can you please be quick? Job chapter 3, I think so. Please be quick. That was the scripture you just brought. Yen intem namin komenim. The book of Job. The book of Job. Oh, we ready, young couple.
Now, Isaiah 7:15 concerning Jesus and his meal.
Hold on, don't go to that. Okay. Let's deal with the book of Job. The candle of the Lord.
Amen. Now, Job 29:4. As I was in the days of my youth, when the secret of God was upon my tabernacle.
No, this is not the secret of man.
It is the secret of God. You have to understand that contrary to what is propagated popularly, the one who speaks against candles is the one who is not from God.
What he said, so far or you should candle in free yami. So far better say, so far no cassette candle, a mum na em free yami.
Now you've heard that anyone who uses candles as a prophetic token is not from God. Today, the man of God, Pastor Obed, is saying that he who rather speaks against candles is not from God. Job 29:4 is clear on this.
Nyankopon was secret.
Yes.
God has a secret. As I was in the days of my youth, when the secret of God was upon my tabernacle. Verse 5.
When the Almighty was yet with me,
when
my children were about me, when I washed my steps with butter.
Tobo, aya fa enkuto, fa enkuto. What's it? Nyami secret.
As part of the secret of God, Job is making us understand that he washed his steps with butter. It is a secret of God.
And he said, obesanso asra wa pampem engo. He anointed my head with oil. And was in my cup ran it over. And to see cup ebrea wunyan. Aya wonta anointed yourself intra.
Now, you are financially handicapped because you do not anoint yourself with oil. David said that he anointed my head with oil, so my cup runneth over. You want your cup to run over, anoint your head with oil.
Nafa enkuto esra.
And wash your steps with butter.
Emana mo garibia otenas no asra no asra no asra no asra ba onim sunsum nti wo ye no na mani ba ndemedia ho ahinta se me ye sunsum na ebrewo.
Now I've revealed the mystery behind applying butter to you. Probably at first you were doing it without spiritual understanding. Now handle it as a conscious process. Know what it is you are doing when you apply butter, especially to your feet.
Bisa hu se sisi ani wenya asem. no akwa kofa balm of Gilead no abompae no dia sra na asem no ko esi den na wo sra nku ema wunya interview appointment esi den na wo sra nku ema wunya visa appointment wunya wo visa esi den na wo sra nku ema bibia eha wo efiri wo soko
obi phone kra sey
osra phone so phone ni na aye ejuma enko fo si die ni.
Now, one of the potent tokens we have on the mountain of God, CCI, is the balm of Gilead. How come just by application of this butter, a lot of sick people, even to the extent of paralyzed people, get back up on their feet? There are gadgets that are sports that have balm of Gilead applied on them, and then they begin to work again. People have secured visa appointments. People have secured job appointments just by using balm of Gilead. How does this happen?
And Mama Wehu, say, secret of God, no? A business to say, a more quantity, a ya tasra wanasi em kuto, na fa and cron cron go a pump him. Now for the 2 to verse 3.
So I've made you know that as part of the secret of God, you need to wash your steps frequently with butter and you also need to anoint your head with oil.
All that I wear, as in man's past. As in the days when God preserved me. How? 3. When his candle. Njo nyame wo candle, wo sori akase ti a candle. Nyame ankasa e wo candle.
God himself has a candle. Yet
when his
you are
candle
speaking against candles
upon my head. When God's candle shine into me, so for be akase ti a candle. Tie the fact to say bon sam nyuma fo e use candle. Enchre say obi a oh, you should can do one yamimuno. It is said, Obia bon sam nasman. Bible, a book. Of course, it's a more book. And you won't mean sorry, Cassentia Bible.
Now, the Bible is a book. All occult groups also have their books. The fact that the Bible is a book doesn't mean that you should speak against the Bible because occults also use books.
And you know, Quran and Muslim for a use. Ekase tia Quran, enkase ntia Bible Christo ni, obi obeka se tia Bible bi emfiri nyame. San obi asusu obeka sa etia candle, san se obi a won firi nyame use candle. Na won so a won nyame mu use candle, obi obeka se tia candle use. E won nyame asori mu no, won so so won firi nyame.
Now understand that the candle is an element and can be employed both ways, both by God, as we see that God has a candle, and by the devil. Now, the fact that you see the devil use a candle doesn't mean that a believer using a candle makes him false or states that he's not from God, because the original source and God himself has a candle, as we see in Job.
And
you talked about baptism. You talked about feet washing. You talked about butter. Also linked it with oil on the head.
Uh-huh.
You spoke about the candle.
And you say I have 5.
Okay. Oil and head, the butter, and the boom.
Okay. And you have Dadwa. Miensa. Minchre Wadi. Oba, sorry. 31st, that done. Metro ni adi dadwa miensa nbeye.
Now, there's also another mystery behind using the prophetic token of 3 nails. I'm not going to go into that here. On 31st, come to church. I'll show you what to do with the 3 nails.
Ni ato subium. Okay, mami nkani tiawa. Hey. Obia enye sika hu ejuma efri se. Yanom eba gaso. Enti koye u sika hu ejuma. Koye u sika hu ejuma. Afi bi ansa na be rafi no mu. Onzi e wa afi 2022. Utie mi ye pa. Ye be ra afi 2023. Me se me che. Me se ye 8 mu ma chere 5.
Baba chere 5. O chere 6.
En exam chere 6 na na agro negu.
Na ka 2.
Na me se me chere 1. Na mbi aba be si 5 yi. Okay. Ma me chere we nka.
Now, you have to understand that your money is an important tool that must go through certain spiritual directions and fortifications before you enter into every new year. I said I was going to teach just one. I've gone beyond 5. I'm on the 6th. Let me just go into this. After this, because I even see a lot of men of God busily writing.
Yeah. Now, so far,
let it be a blessing, and as men of God, you too be a blessing to your people.
My floor director says time.
My floor director says it's time.
Afibia obe remono pomodiana pe bay leaf.
Get a bay leaf.
Say a year 2022 chro 22 emprenu ewoso. A year 2021 at chro 21 emprenu ewoso. Say year 2023 at chro 23 emprenu ewoso. Ura 2024 chro 24 ewoso.
Now another token, just like I said, you should get three nails is to get three bay leaves. Depending on the year you are entering into, you write that year. So 2021, you write 21 twice. 2022, you write 22 twice. And so on and so forth. What would you use these leaves for? You have to be here on 31st night. Crossover service. I'll show you what to do.
From the 10th to the 13th, you have to be here on the for communion ne tosubium bo modia na woro na ase ne tosubium penkutobo sompae aya wo de asra wo na ase ne tosubium pe anointing oil aya wo de gu wa pampem ne tosubium pe candle na between 10th and 13th no sona bom pae say rade ye me han na di menim ana afi ne toato aso ne de 31st a ebe. But modern so be baby cha esu sanani be miracle puno and sentreni su tanano be chebi wati.
Now I said I was going to speak of eight things, just to go through them quickly. I spoke of the communion, I spoke of the baptism, whose activity is just like feet washing. I spoke of using the candle. We saw how that God has his candle. You have to use the candle between the 10th of and 13th of December, especially to secure your life ahead. Now, I've spoken about getting three nails. I didn't show you what to do with it. I spoke about getting three bay leaves and writing the figures of the year ahead on them, and I didn't show what to do with it. You are supposed to meet me with these tokens on the 31st night. Also, make sure that you cross the miracle pool wherever you are as we enter into the new year. For what I've given explanations and details to, make sure you undertake those directions. Now, for the four aspects of the directions that you can undertake, make sure you do not take it lightly. Undertake them in this season.
Pe enkutu a eye wo special spiritual enkutu. E no no de ye wo spiritual activity.
You have to
enkutu na de bia wo sra no kwa no. Ene de ye for special. Na enkutu a ye de sra no, o make sure say wo na ase ebedi bi.
Now, you have to understand this. I want you to get special butter. Butter meant for spiritual activity. I want you to separate this from the normal butter you use. However, also when you're applying butter to your skin, make sure that you concentrate on your feet.
Akani aka. Eye radiad ma 31st. Muntemi. Me ba be bo de ruse. O ba 31st na fania me bi bra. E niyama na meka se fa bra. E san se wube tra fininti. E na me ma ode sa niyama na ba.
Now.
Kai. Na shenin su se afi ensua be tokane eya kwanchre first rainwater of the year eya kwanchre a janus osuro kese na do amiensa eya kwanchre janus obetwene ho tie na tie ni ye bay leaf eya spiritual thunderbolt a janus ontumi nyina no eno nso so 31st ni de me de nyinyara 8 nyinyara begu from me pemre 30 minutes to 1 hour na ma chirechire nyinyara ye ba ni amachire oyi 10th to the 13th en fe ni agro for communion de bia bo modi aso be woro na so ku adwa ye wie na adware wi abompa ye gu nsuo ni biso na fe gu na ase bo modi ase o de candle ebe bompa ye candle white enye colored candle bia ye nchire candle and their colors enye hu ahintasem candle per candle face baby album pie and I would them na so na bomb pie say eradin ya wohan non fa wuncha afin rafi fufrum bomodiana penkuto bosom pie san kuto ne nyusuno basabasa eye wo special spiritual butter and chi ni yen kuto ne no no oh yeah, na di asra, be mumu asra, maybe in corners because unyeska, ebiacha December into January no. Na eno ne ye job ni si kenyemu ni nara ne hin tasem. Afedie, bomodi anape dadwa mi ense biguo. Na fe shia mi 31st. Pe believe ni ense biguo. Fe shia mi 31st. Ni aka no, meba TV so aba be bo hu deru. But between now and the 13th, e ho akwanchira wudi secure way, and am bia gufom se, penkuto. Pension uro na ase. Pe communion bosom pa ye Yesu moja nanum.
Now, I've spoken about two aspects of the direction, mentioned about 6 to 7 things that you should do. The first aspect of the directions has to do with what you should do now between the 10th and the 13th. Make sure you take communion very seriously in this period.
Yes.
Number two, get butter, like I said, special butter dedicated to spiritual activity.
Yes.
Pray over the butter. Apply it on your body, especially your feet, because you want to secure your wealth for the upcoming year.
The secret of Job.
The secret of Job, as we saw. Another secret of Job we saw was the candle. Get a candle. Light it. Let it be in your room. Whilst you pray, let that candle be present. Secure your life and let God be your light as you enter into the new year and the coming year. Now, I spoke about the fact that you should get 3 bills. You should get 3 bay leaves, writing the figures of the incoming year on the leaf. Now, this is what you should do. You are supposed to meet me on the 31st crossover service here in CCI Kumasi or any of our networks or even the virtual church. And I'm going to have time. Spend about 30 minutes to 1 hour to go through all these 8 I've spoken about already and then give specific directions as to what you should do. Now, beyond the bay leaves and beyond the nails, I'm going to come back on air and mention other things that you should get. So make sure you are staying tuned to Cosmopolitan TV and all our social media channels so that you'll be adequately prepared. Finally, make sure you are here or in any of our networks to cross the miracle pool on the 31st night crossover service. The Lord bless you. The Lord grace you.
Na adoya na mpese me ye oba ko na macho wisien.
I wanted to give you 1 gift. I ended up giving you 6.
Aka mienu.
2 more.
Me say 31st.
31st.
Mema wo di ade ehia me.
I'll let you meet me here with something.
Ni aye sunsun mu ni ameguso.
We are going to undertake spiritual acts.
Na wo di rafi fufu.
You enter the new year fortifying yourself.
Baby biara wo.
Wherever you are,
she achedia nyame nam na ko aso e dia ma okwa.
Look at the gifts God has given you through his servant.
Na de radiase e wa afforibodie mu.
And be thankful through your offertory and giving.
Entie ni se weti akwanchre ukoye ne kwa e wa bra wo mu akwanchre ne so afforie.
Do not just take it that you've received prophetic tokens and directions without sowing and keying into the blessing that accompanies.
Shimu phone na fa chre TV ne nim sisia.
Pick your phone. Pointed towards the screen.
May be bomb pie ama wodua yeba for ye and ne anope.
I'm going to pray for all of you who are giving and sowing into this.
And someone abba and nami and saying ehuye.
I've spoken about heavy matters, grave matters in the past 3 days. I've revealed mysteries, I've opened eyes spiritually.
Mama wahunu bosumi ni ye toso.
I've made you know concerning the month of December and January what happens, what's actually the spiritual condition of the season and how to be a victor. I do not want you to only give an offertory on your head. I want you to give an offertory on the head of your wife, of your children, of your dad, of your mom, of all people who are around you who you can call your own, to make sure that their lives are secured as we enter into the new year. Plead with the Lord that as these teachings have come,
as
I sow these seeds even in line with these teachings, bless me, protect me, fortify me and all that is mine. Let me cross this year because there's a plot of the evil one to water the land with blood. But it is not my head, nor my blood, nor the head of my family, nor the blood of my family.
we si po sinkonya aye na dwene se ode wu moja uma moja ukunu moja ana aye aye twa ohwehia wadofo moja ebe pete asase ne so no ba forie se nyame aforie yisu namso na jemekra every of the self for every the sumso.
Whoever has set himself as an adversary, as an opposition, who has set himself as a wicked person to ensure that your blood is used to water the land, you are sowing the seed, crying out to God, saying that minus you, minus your wife, minus your children, minus your family, minus all that is yours, you have received divine immunity and exemption from this evil plot of the enemy.
Whoever,
God bless everyone who sows into this.
Send the Sam Momo no Ebra numbers ne wo screen no.
Send for here. Send your offerings to the numbers on the screen.
Jidia for here.
A seed of faith.
O crash one for here.
Your soul offering.
Me chao na ma bompaya ma.
I'm waiting for you to pray for you. If you are outside the country, you want to use any mobile money sending platform, any international mobile money sending platform. You can use Wave, you can use ZPay, you can use WorldRemit. The numbers to send your seeds to are +233-247-036-136. +233-247-036-136. The other number is +233-543-850-876. +233-543-850-876. Also, you are in Ghana, you want to use the short code *447*248#. *447*248#. Wherever you are in Ghana, whatever network you use, just dial in this short code, follow the voice prompts, the command prompts, and sow your seed.
Even as the man of God connected to CCI platform and Kebeya short code no Ghana, they are saving. Save no say CCI of a tree line. Enti abri bia e beka se ye ba for ye. Ah ye mo star o si dey 4
star 447
star 447
star 248 hash.
Star 248 hash. Save no phone no so. Ni nya ka se ye ba for ye na wako ho. No send it ni yes or the send it. Send it na mo mpa ye ma.
Now the man of God is entreating you if you are in Ghana. You are resident here. With whichever network you use to communicate via mobile, store this code as the CCI offertory line. It's *447*248, so that anytime you're supposed to give any kind of offertory, you just go through this means. Now, mind you, not only can you give your offertory through this line, it's our prompt line for all givings we receive. So now, you can pay your partnership levies through this means. You can give towards the building project through this means. You can send in your tithe through this means. This short code is the avenue by which, if you are in Ghana, with ease, you can send in any offertory to CCI, to Christ Cosmopolitan Incorporated, to the man of God, Pastor Obed, as you are connected. Short code again is *447*248#. Save it, follow the prompts, and give.
Father, in the name of Jesus, stretch forth your phone, my dear beloved in Christ, towards the screen as I stretch my hand towards you. Obi biara wo ba for ye bi. Fa phone chre screen no so. E wa bra me bom paye amawi.
If you gaze, stretch forth your phone towards the screen as I pray for you.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Dodo amomai.
For all those who gave.
Nyame onkomo mwa.
The Lord help you.
Why you shra?
You've become a blessing. Whatever rises up against
you,
I cancel it, that which is against you, as we end this year and we enter into the new year. I pray to God that blessing you have received should go from generation to generation. Even in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. I promised that I was going to receive calls today. I said I will be a different thing when I come live. As we are entering into the new year, we are going to climb up a spiritual ladder. We are going to walk and advance with fast
pace.
It's going to be a special year for you. Loved one, beloved.
Ekwa koma se oni mi din koma friend numbers na wo screen no.
Now, we are going to have a calling session. Also, if you're in social media, you're probably outside the country, you might want to type your comments. Now, this has been a three-day journey. Let us know what impact this season of three-day special breakthrough morning devotion has had on you. Let us know what you've received. You probably already have a testimony from day one to day three. God has come through for you already in a special way. Type it in the comment section. Let me know what God has done for you. Let's read, share your testimony. Let's share your experience. You probably have special words to tell Papa. You have words to tell the brethren as are listening from far and wide. Let us know what God has done for you. We are going to announce the call lines. +233 55 128 248. +233 55 128 248. You want to call in, you want to speak with the man of God, Pastor Obed. He's going to pray specially for you. Now, we are going to pick a limited number of calls. So, you're in Ghana, you want to call +233 55 128 2428. Not only for you in Ghana, you are anywhere in the world, +233 55 128 248, and the Lord is here ready for you. You want to call in right now to speak with a man of God. You want to type in your comments. You can probably even type in special prayer request. More importantly, you want to type in how much of a blessing this season of 3 day special breakthrough morning devotion has been to you, and what you've received, how God has come through for you, how God has touched you, how God has touched your family, how God has touched everyone who came into contact with this. We have Emmanuel Diaso on the line.
Emmanuel, hello. Hello, Emmanuel. Emmanuel, hello. Can you hear us, Emmanuel? Emmanuel Diaso, hello.
If you still want to know the call lines, we have +233 55 128. Emmanuel Bartholomew, he says, Pastor Obed, if there is great blessing anywhere,
amen,
I pray you receive that blessing.
Amen. Papa Shalom. I receive.
Papa, if there is great blessing anywhere,
I receive that great blessing.
So that me too, I can receive some.
Amen.
Pastor Obed, always a blessing.
Amen.
God bless you, Papa. God
Amen.
Bless you. Sorry, I'm not mentioning your names. I'm blessed exceedingly. God bless you mightily, Papa. It's always refreshing to spend time with you. This
Amen.
From Justice Kwating. We love you, Papa. Nanaya says, God bless you, Daddy. I'm too much blessed
Amen.
For this 3 days breakthrough. Do we have Emmanuel on the line now?
Emmanuel. Hello.
Papa, while we wait for the line to be connected, Konfanko Nanedu Berema says, I have a
Konfanko.
Yes.
Konfanko.
Okay.
Yeah, Konfanko. Hey.
Sorry, I was just taking the time. Papa, sorry. And so he says that he has a special prayer request for protection for himself and divine health into the coming year.
I declare in the name of Jesus, Konfanko, wherever you are, let the grace of divine protection and health be your portion. In Jesus' mighty name, I call it done. Amen.
Amen. Paul Obed Cortez says, I receive so much insights concerning this being in the coming year. God bless you, Papa. Mavis in the Eastern region.
Hello, Sister Mavis. Hello, Sister Mavis. Hello.
Hello. Well, while we wait for the line to be connected, Konfanko Nanedu Berema says, Konfanko. Yes, Konfanko. Yes, Konfanko. Sorry, I was just thinking it.
Phobie Ebenezer says, God bless you, Papa, for such a key to enter into the coming year. Now, you have a special prayer request. You have something special to tell the man of God. You can type it in the comment section on Facebook. Type it in the comment section on YouTube. You can also try calling in the line. God bless you, teacher and prophet of all time.
Amen.
But I don't know who has many more titles in this body of Christ. you are given different names at different times. Anyway.
So being a blessing, that's what it comes
yes,
with.
Yes, Papa, it comes with that. Do we have Mavis on the line now? The call lines are +233 55 128 2428 +233 55 128 2428. Vicky Parry says, I connect from Nigeria. I am so blessed with these 3 days of open eye teaching. scales fell off my eyes.
Amen.
Pastor Obed, you will not miss your reward here and hereafter.
Amen.
God bless you, Papa.
I receive.
Joseph Nikwe, you are asking how you can connect on the 31st. Now, just start watching this transmission from the beginning. You will know how you can connect from the 31st. We have Priscilla on the line. Priscilla, you are on the line.
Hello.
Shalom, Daddy.
Shalom, Sister Priscilla. How are you doing?
Please, I'm fine. And thank you so much. God bless you for being teaching us for these 3 days.
Amen.
It has been a blessing unto myself and unto my family.
I thank God for your life.
Amen. And then I look through that through next year, the directions and the new things you have taught us will bring us new breakthroughs.
Sure, it will. It works. And it will deliver as you expect in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
I pray for you concerning 2023. I declare you blessed. I declare your family blessed. I declare that the highways and the byways are cleared. Every channel spirit that would want to touch your money and frustrate, I curse out of the way in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Bella Victor says, man of God, you have indeed launched us into the deep. Yes, the deep indeed. God bless you abundantly. What a blessing you are indeed.
Amen.
I ask for prayer restoration of my mom's sanity and health.
I declare that the sanity of your mom is restored right now in the name of Jesus. Receive that breakthrough of miracle. I call it done. Amen.
Felicia says that, Papa, please pray for me to gain admission into the university.
Receive your admission, Felicia, in the name of Jesus. We call it done. Amen.
Edward says, hey, Pastor Obed.
Adumarakwa.
God bless you for revealing these secrets to us. Amen.
Amen.
Now, this is your handle. Sue Ann. He says, from New York. Please pray a quick prayer for my breakthrough to manifest before the year ends.
I pray that the grace of God will bring you quick breakthroughs in Jesus' name. I call it done. Amen.
Priscilla Sundong says, Pastor, please pray for my son to be employed permanently into Goldfields Company Limited in Takwa.
Goldfields, let the gates open, even in the name of Jesus, for this testimony to be established. Glory to God in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. It's not too late to share the link. It's not too late to call a loved one. We are this Kairos time of calling in to speak with a man of God. Share the link, share the link, share the link. If you do not share the link, you are not doing well. Copy the link from YouTube, Facebook, share it on WhatsApp status, share it across all your social media platforms. We are live with a man of God, Pastor Obed. We are having a call-in session. People are bringing in their prayer requests. Make sure you connect. Priscilla from Pristia is on the line.
Sister Priscilla, shalom. How are you? Hello, Sister Priscilla. Shalom.
Vicky Paris says, I connect from Nigeria.
Hello, Sister Priscilla. Shalom.
So, Papa, we have Otis Ledlum. He says, God bless you, Papa. I just remembered once when I was prompted to buy food for a madman. When I did, I was shocked, and he said, God bless you. I now understand everything. God bless you.
God bless
for giving me understanding. Mary Opai says, please pray for my daddy and grandma. They are not feeling well.
I command that, Mary, your dad and your grandma are healed right now. The sick bed they are on, I change it into a health bed.
In Jesus' name,
amen.
Priscilla from Pristia, are you online now?
Yes, please.
Hello, Sister Priscilla. Shalom.
Shalom, Daddy.
How are you doing?
I'm blessed, Daddy.
All right. Can we hear why you called?
Yes, Daddy. God bless you so much.
Amen.
I've been following CCI. I've been there once as well.
Okay.
And God bless you so much.
Amen.
And Daddy, please, I need a break, please. I've been working for 13 years plus now.
All right.
And then, I don't know, I've been struggling with my promotion. I've been praying, and I believe the altar can speak.
I declare in the name of Jesus that as you connect to this platform, the breakthrough you've been believing for, as you use butter to wash your feet, and as you light candles through the night, in the name of Jesus, the 10th, the 11th, and the 12th, may it release that breakthrough you're looking
in
for.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, I call it done. Amen.
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 God bless you, Sister Priscilla. God bless you.
Miss Nyonyo says, Shalom, Daddy. I'm not going to give chance to these directions at all. Papa, she means God bless you a lot. Emmanuel J says, God bless you for such an insightful journey in these 3 days. Papa, speak forth a word into my life and family.
I speak forth a word of power. Mm. It is settled in your life. Mm. In Jesus' name, amen.
Raphael Elom Samaglo says, God richly bless you, Papa, for opening our eyes into these truths. I know it will change our lives for good. Nana Koto Kumi Emmanuel, Papa, you are more than a blessing. This is from CCI Australia.
God
Auckland
bless you.
Auckland Network. He says, we pray for protection, prosperity, and divine encounters in the months ahead of December and January.
God bless you, all members in Auckland, all the way in Australia. I declare in the name of Jesus, the hand of God and the hand of power is upon you to preserve you, to take the land. In Jesus' name, amen.
Agnes from Bole is on the line, Papa.
Sister Agnes, shalom.
Shalom, Pastor.
How are you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Happy hearing from you.
Yeah, I am blessed this morning. God richly bless you.
Amen. You are lifted.
Amen.
All right. Why do you put in a call at this time?
Yes, I am sick and I need prayer for healing.
What is wrong with you?
Yeah, I have rashes all over my body.
I declare that the rashes should burn.
In the name of Jesus.
I declare that the rashes should leave.
In the name of Jesus.
I command it to leave you and I curse the rashes in your skin at the roots.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. Amen. Sister Agnes, are you close to a water body behind your house?
Yes, I'm by a dump.
Yes, quickly. I just saw it. Quickly, go in there, fetch some of the water. Don't add anything to it, no soap. Bring it and use it to wash your body. Repeat it for 3 days. It is done in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Just do it right away. God bless you. Bye-bye.
God bless you, bye.
Papa Osborne Opoku asks for prayer for his sister Betty to go through post-birth issues.
I declare in the name of Jesus, every issues that have become anything worrying this dear sister, I command in the name of Jesus, complications cease by the power of the Holy Ghost. We call it done. Amen.
Agnes Pebble says, pray against uterine fibroids.
I command that the fibroids should melt and fall off your body in Jesus' name. Amen.
Leroy Lily says, God bless you, Pastor. I'm Leroy Lily, watching you live from Liberia.
I command that all of you watching from Liberia be blessed. Mm. Next year, I'm on my way to Sierra Leone. I'm coming to Liberia. Mm. May the grace of God rest upon you.
In Jesus' name,
I call it done. Amen.
Linda Nayere from Salaga says, God richly bless you. Please pray for me and my family for financial upliftment.
Release of finances from on high into this family right now in Jesus' name. Amen.
Ebenezer from Accra is on the line, Papa.
Brother Eben, how are you? Shalom.
Shalom, Pastor Eben. How are you too?
I'm blessed and good, favored.
Yeah, for these 3 days, in fact, we are so blessed.
God Amen.
Bless you.
Amen.
And empowered by your
Amen.
By your direction.
I thank also, God.
I have applied for a Canadian visa.
It is done.
And it is not in yet.
It so is I settled. Need. It is done.
Amen.
Go
and
for
my
it.
My wife too, also put up with the hand, very painful. You don't know how serious it is.
Is your wife close by?
Yes, please.
Don't let her touch the front of the screen. She should touch the back of the screen right now. The back of the TV set, not the front. The back of the TV set. Let her touch it right now.
Okay. She's here.
Let her touch the back of the TV set. Hello, my dear sister. How are you?
Hello, Papa.
All right, my dear sister, how are you?
I'm fine. I'm blessed, Papa.
Now take note of what I'm about to do for you right now by the power of God. In the name of Jesus, as you touch the back of the TV set, may power go through the screens right now. Into that sick part of your body, in Jesus' precious name, I call it done. Amen.
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 Now watch
Thank
me.
You.
No, we are not done.
Okay.
Now watch me. Breathe in 3 times. Receive 1. Receive 2.
Jesus.
Receive 3. Now begin to do what you couldn't do with the hand right now. I'm taking this testimony right now. What was wrong with your hand?
My hand, I couldn't straighten it.
Straighten it now.
Yes, I can do it.
As simple as that. Glory to God.
Glory.
God bless you so much.
Amen. Amen.
Thank
amen.
You, thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm healed.
That's it. Glory to God. Amen. Oh, amen. Keep that healing.
The pain is gone.
Amen. 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 Adum, Adum, Adum. Adum, Adum, Adum. Yo, and come on. Amen. All right. Amen. Next caller. Next caller.
Adote says, hey, please don't joke with Papa's directions. Oh, they work more than magic and air. In fact, me and Kasa and my family are living proof. Indeed,
God bless you.
You have no size.
This is no magic. This is the power of God.
Paul Obed Cote says, Papa, please pray for me for a speedy connection with my destiny helpers. And also, I ask for spiritual protection for my father and family.
May the network of divine destiny helpers be arranged for you right now, Obed Paul, in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Judah says, Shalom, Papa. I've been diagnosed with polycystic ovarian syndrome and barely have my monthly flow. Please pray for me.
I'm praying for you right now in the name of Jesus, and I declare that every PCOS is leaving your body
in Jesus' name. Jesus.
Amen.
Beatrice from Takrade is on the line.
Sister
Papa.
Beatrice, Shalom.
Yes, Pastor.
Shalom, Sister Beatrice.
Shalom, Pastor. Thank you for the morning breakthrough.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you so much.
Amen.
For having you in our life.
I thank God.
Yes, I need prayer.
What do you want God to do for you?
I want God to delete fibroid in my system.
Fibroid. Fibroid. I command in the name of Jesus. Quickly, listen to me. Sister Beatrice, listen right away. Sister Beatrice, listen. I'm telling you this. Somebody is quarreling with you. I just saw it. Obiniwoku. And this happened in the past 2 weeks. Onipa neye behind your fibroid.
In the name of Jesus.
Send your ye biara.
In the name of Jesus.
With Jesus Christ, demon.
Receive your healing right now. Receive your healing right now. Receive your healing right now.
Adumunti. Amen.
Amen. I have financial problems.
Amen.
Amen.
When I pray for you, he handles everything. Receive your wealth, your finances. Ingozi, all the way from Nigeria. Papa Shalom, I need your prayers. And pray for my husband. He's
tell
under
Ingozi.
Satanic.
No. Tell Ingozi from Nigeria, there is this migraine headache that is beginning to affect your sense of smell. By the power of the Holy Ghost, I command that you and your husband should be sorted out.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, receive your healing. And every satanic manipulation against your husband, we break it by the power of the Holy Ghost.
In the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name, Ingozi be healed.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Malika Martin says, good morning, Pastor. I'm in the UK asking for prayers for my sister Rita to get funding for our study here in the UK.
Malika, be blessed.
In the name of
Malika,
Jesus.
Malika, I release funding.
In the name of Jesus.
I release scholarship.
In the name of Jesus.
I release it right now.
In the
now,
name of Jesus.
That the God of all possibilities who is at work on this mountain should remember you in Jesus' name. Amen. Sister Juan, Shalom.
Joan from Cape Coast, you're on the line.
Sister Joan, Shalom.
Hi, Shalom, Daddy.
How are you?
I'm doing well, Daddy. God bless you so much.
Amen. Calling all the way from Cape Coast.
Yes, Daddy.
Okay, let us hear you.
Yes, I'm praying for speed in my marriage.
All right.
Yes, speed, because it seems it's delaying small.
What are you looking for in your marriage?
I'm yet to get married. You promised that by November it will happen, but it's delaying.
Don't worry. Don't worry. There will be 2 months more delay. Listen to me. There will be 2 months more delay. But in the third month, And I'm seeing that in March, everything is sorted out. God bless
Amen.
You. In Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. From-
Hold on. Let me talk to Joanne. Sister Joanne.
Daddy.
Mo pocho ehun de enwin bi rifu wo wo kona se ha ehun enwin bi rifu wo ho.
I don't understand tree.
There is hair growing under this part of your body. I don't know if you've seen it.
Yes.
Hair. Quickly yes. cut it. It's wape wa wa nanyin.
Okay.
Go and do it right now. Yes. Cut it right now, Jesus. So you can't say I receive my marriage.
That's it. Just cut that hair that is growing. Declare that you've received your marriage and that is it.
Glory to
Amen.
God. Glory to Amen. God. Go and do it. And when you get married, please send me your wedding pictures, all right?
I'll do that. Then.
Yes, yes, yes. So quickly, go cut it. That thing is what is causing the retrogression.
Okay.
Yes.
I'm doing this right.
Cut.
Amen. Yes.
Nabaho says, Shalom, Papa. Can you pray that I'm protected from household enemies and all sorts of enemies who have risen against me and my family and finances?
I command, Brother Sam, where you are, receive breakthroughs.
In the name of Jesus.
Receive turnaround. Receive upliftment in your finances. And every household enemy is brought down. In the name of Jesus, for your sake, God bless you. I call it done. Joanna, I love you. Elijah, Obed, I love you all. God richly bless you. Bye-bye.
Dominic, you are our last caller. Dominic, you are our last caller if you're on the line.
Dominic from Cape, Dominic from Bibieni.
Yes, Papa, from
Dominic
BBN.
From Bibieni. Shalom.
Shalom. Shalom, man of God.
How are you doing?
I'm doing well, man of God. How
glorious. I'm wonderful.
Thank you.
How may we be a blessing to you?
Yes, yes, you have been amazing. It's,
Amen.
It's been an amazing experience with you.
Amen.
Thank you for the expose.
Amen.
I am very, very pleased to be talking to you this morning.
I'm also happy to hear from you.
Thank you.
God bless you. Any requests for prayer? Okay, you just wanted to say thank you to me and God bless me. And I say to you, God bless you too in Jesus' name. But before you go, and Brad Dominic, are you having this knee condition, like this restriction in the knee?
Hello?
Hello, Brad Dominic. Any issue with your knee? Your knee?
Yes.
Your knee?
Yes.
I declare in the... Yes, talk to me.
I had a dream I think last week.
All right.
Where I encountered with dead people, had issues with dead people. So I'll be pleased if you
were not listening to me. I'm going to pray against that spirit of the dead that is following you. But I'm asking you of a condition in your knee. Your knee.
Yes, sir.
Are you having any condition in your knee? I'm praying for you right now.
Okay.
In the name of Jesus, I declare by the power of God, any issue with your knee, any accident projected against you, I destroy it and I command it backfired and I declare that that sensation of numbness from the knee down to your leg is over in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God
now,
bless you.
For all of you who have, there are numerous prayer requests, there are numerous messages.
Mm.
I couldn't read all of them, but just know that every single prayer
request, as I lift up my hand towards
in the
heaven,
name of Jesus.
I declare it is released, it is settled
in the name
to
of
the
Jesus.
Glory of God.
In, the name
in
of
Jesus',
Jesus'
precious name, amen.
Amen. So for those of you fighting with me in the comment section, the man of God has prayed for you. We couldn't take all of them. We couldn't take all the calls. But we'll come your way again, surely, with another special session. You know, the man of God comes your way seasonally with such an opportunity to speak with him, to call in and to receive blessings. Know that that day will come again, and God is always ready to strike that hand towards you wherever you are.
Don't forget that every Wednesday morning, we have Breakthrough Morning Devotion from 5:45 a.m. exactly. Please make it a point. We are back live, strong, more anointed, favored with grace and power to be of a blessing to you. And I want you to know that this particular month, before we enter the coming year, stick with me on Cosmopolitan TV. And know that every person who is connected with me on this platform, I'm always praying for you. You are dear on my heart. Remain blessed, viewer, who is connected on Cosmopolitan TV. Papa, I have one last caller.
Lord Director made an exception for someone calling all the way from Nigeria.
So all right. Let me hear you from Nigeria. What's her name?
Dorcas Benson from Nigeria. Shalom, Papa.
Shalom, Sister Dorcas. How are you?
Fine. It's a great privilege to have you.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I've been trying you online, but it doesn't go through.
Sorry.
I'm a first-time caller now.
Yes. Happy to hear from you. What do you want God to do for you?
Papa, I need breakthrough.
Amen.
I need breakthrough.
Amen.
I don't forget my dreams. I don't remember my dreams. I have marks all over my body when I wake up at times.
You have marks on your body?
Pray for me, Papa.
All right. You wake up and you see marks on your body?
Yes.
Don't worry. Let me show you what to do. Just get camphor, put it in oil, and leave it standing for 3 days, and then use it for the next 3 days to rub your body, and on the 7th day put salt in water and bath with it. That's it. It's over.
Jesus'
name. Okay. I hope you heard me clearly.
Yes.
Camphor in oil for 3 days, then use the oil to rub your body for 3 days. On the 7th day put salt in water and bath with it. And now, you evil being that puts string marks in the body, I curse you. And by this token of abomination, I drive you away.
In the name of
Jesus. I declare that this breaks you off her skin and her back. And now I release breakthroughs in your workplace. I release breakthroughs for your job. Finances for you. I declare it is settled. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Bless you, Papa. Papa, finally, I want to tell some of you with certain medical conditions. They are week in, week out, every single Sunday. The man of God is a blessing to people through the healing and miracle line. You've probably been watching Cosmopolitan TV, or you've not seen us on TV at all. Week in, week out, the man of God specially ministers to people concerning bodily ailments, for those who require divine intervention, for those who by one way or the other are going through spiritual oppressions. The testimonies abound. So I would want you to take an extra step. If you have any such condition, just call the numbers that are displayed on your screen every time. Make a request. Talk to the one who speaks to you and let him know that you want to come to be ministered to specially by the man of God. And I know that as you do so, you'll be the next person in line for a testimony.
Just know that 31st crossover is coming off at a CCI auditorium at Skorimampong. The miracle pool is hitting up. The grace of God, the message of the Lord, the prophetic word for the season, I'll release it at the 31st crossover service. Please make it a point to be a part of the experience. Your life surely will never be the same. Don't enter the year without undertaking spiritual tokens to secure your life. I am here ever praying for you. I'm here expecting you to be there. Service begins at exactly 5 p.m. 5 p.m. We start service at 5 p.m. Arrive way earlier so that you can have a good place to be seated in the auditorium. It's happening at Asokorimampong, our church premises. And again, in all of our networks across the country and across the globe, wherever CCI is closest to you, locate it and be a part of the experience. You know what? I'm praying over the miracle pool, and I am also going to be sending portions of the water of the pool in gallons to be sent to all the networks and mixed with the water over there, so that the same grace that is upon the pool would also be in all the networks as well. Make it a point to be here or to be in any of our networks. The experience is going to be grand.
Yeah.
In Accra, in Cape Coast, in Takoradi, in Ho, everywhere, in Mampong, in Tamale, in Sunyani, everywhere, in Techiman, wherever you are, take notes. CCI is closest to you. Be part of the crossover experience with the man of God, Pastor Obed, and your life surely will blossom and never be the same. again.
Amen. Now, for all the information concerning the various networks and stations where we are going to have the crossover service, just you are watching the live stream on Facebook or on YouTube, it will be left in the repository. Just start the transmission from the beginning. All the information, all the contact numbers that you need to have to be able to attend a network anywhere are available. Now, the man of God made you understand that the service for crossover is starting at 5 p.m. If you are in Kumasi and its environs, buses to church will start moving at 3 p.m. Now, like he said, you want to make sure you come early so that you take your seat. Papa, last year, as early as 12 p.m. and 1 p.m., people were already on the ground.
Flocking in.
So if a service is starting at 5 and by 12 and 1, people are already here, you need to make sure that you come early so that you can secure a good seat and then have that wonderful experience with God, even through his choice servant, Pastor Obed Obeade. We are in CCI Georgia. We are in CCI Vietnam. We are in CCI Australia. So you are outside the country and you can make it a point. Probably Ghana is too far from where you are, but you can travel to the US. You can travel to, that's Georgia. You can travel to Vietnam. You can travel to Australia. I want you to call those numbers. Like I said, go to the beginning of the stream, call those numbers, get in touch with our personnel, and they'll make you know how best arrangements can be made for you so that you can have that physical experience in our networks for crossover service. Again, I remind you that we are taking testimonies for what God has done for you throughout the year. Probably you were at last year's crossover service. You've had an experience with the man of God. A lot of you typed in gracious testimonies by undertaking prophetic directions that the man of God had given. Now, what we want you to do is to record a short video of yourself. You orient your phone this way, just in landscape mode. Record a short video of yourself telling us what God has done for you, how God has come through specially for you, and what your attendance of the crossover service last year has done for you in this year. How you have been distinguished, how you have been made anew by experiencing the miracle pool, the testimonies you've received. Record a short video for us. Send it to the number displayed on your screen. Let us share with the world. Let your testimony abound more and more. Let the faith of others be ignited so that they can multiply. And I know crossover, like the man of God has told you, if you go anywhere else, it is a 30 second. Come for 31st crossover service at CCI. Come and go through the miracle pool.
Amen.
Come and experience the other things he has not spoken about. 31st night every time at CCI. I've attended a number of crossover services here. None of them is the same. Everyone is different. It's a build upon, a build upon, a build upon. God bless you as you take that decision to be here with us.
And so finally, I pray for every viewer who is connected and who called in and who watched with their hearts open wide. Lord, bless them.
Jesus.
And I ask that you'll cause overflowing rivers of blessings to flow our way. Thank you, Lord, for these special 3 days of what you have revealed by your servant and what has fallen on good grounds, which is our hearts. We give you glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And you know what? It's always a wonderful time on Breakthrough Morning Devotion.
In the name of
and
Jesus.
And know that man of God, Pastor Obed, is praying for all viewers on Cosmopolitan TV. This Tuesday, Sun Sumunsem is live.
Gosh.
This Tuesday, Tuesday evening, Sun Sumunsem is live. We are coming your way at 7:45 p.m. sharp. Sun Sumunsem is live this particular Tuesday. And it's going to be explosive. Where? Benada Ebe. Sun Sumunsem. Na ye ye ne dada na. A few ni na ye nye Sun Sumunsem. Benada Ebe. Na. Isuma sem ye hinta semwa. Eban. Anu adin. But mo diya na shenin su. Na 7:45 free we bush for we man on kola we yire wo mo mo ye adwuma ma onyi na fro bia betena se se sofo bed e sansu ni sunsu munsem na ba biem na ni awu no breakthrough morning devotion nya sunsu munsem o ene ne breakthrough morning devotion enje ene ye kas ye kas sunsu munsem dia benada 7:45 sofo bed e ba wa kwem shenin so and be a part of the experience.
Jesus.
You always shout, Pastor Danny, baby, I will approach you. Amen. Bye amen. Bye. Bogawan, Pastor Danny, be see from all better. Benada, no free approach to Ghana. Bye-bye. Medawase. Adumunti. Amen.
December at the CCI Auditorium at Sokore Mampong. The way. On the 31st of December at the CCI Auditorium at Sokore Mampong, the world will be on lockdown for God's mind about 2023. CCI and Cosmopolitan Television presents the only place to be that matters for life and destiny on New Year's Eve. It's Crossover 2022 with Pastor Obed. Join us, give thanks for God's unfailing mercies in 2022 and unravel God's mind for 2023. Experience grace that gives you the advantage as we go through the miracle pool. Service starts at 5 p.m. and buses will start moving from all over the city by 3 p.m. Call 024-703-6136 for inquiries. Crossover 2022 with Pastor Obed. Your glorious 2023 starts here. They